Well, hello, and welcome back to This One Last Call. Like, thank you for joining us today. I decided to go ahead and do an episode on martinis. I'm going to make two different types of martinis. I'm going to make one, which is just going to be a plain old vodka martini, dry. And then I'm going to make the Vesper Martini in honor of the late Sean Connery. Vesper Martini was made famous in the James Bond Casino Royale, where he came up with his own recipe for a martini. I've seen a couple things on a couple videos and such on it. Basically, it's sort of a show-offy type drink. Requires vodka and gin, which is very strange for a martini, and it uses quina lillet, which is no longer made. So, cochi americano is an acceptable substitute. But first, let's just go and do the regular martini. Very easy drink. I actually kind of prefer regular martini over the Vesper, although the Vesper is fine in and of itself. And also, unlike Mr. Bond, we're going to go ahead and stir both of our versions, just because I think that they just come out better that way. Anyways, we'll take your vodka. I'm using French vodka. It is a 5 times distilled vodka. It's fine, it's vodka. Taste is fine. Anyways, you're going to go with 2 ounces. 1, 2. And you're going to do a half an ounce, 3/4 ounce. It's kind of the taste of your vermouth. I've got DeLon dry vermouth. It's pretty good vermouth. Nice citrusy notes to it, a little bit floral herbaceousness to it as well. But more, in my opinion, a little bit more citrus forward. Normally I like to go with a gin on this one, but my gin's running a little low and I wanted to make sure I had enough to make the Vesper. So that's why I'm doing that. Anyways, I'm going to go 3/4 ounce. Don't know why, I just don't particularly care for my martini super dry. If that were the case, I would, you know, just drink it neat. So there you go with that. Just make those two ingredients together. Then you're going to stir. Mr. Ball will be turning in his grave because he prefers his martinis shaken, not stirred. But traditionally it's made stirred. I guess one of the reasons is it keeps the drink clear, which is actually one of the characteristics of vodka martini, is that it's very clear. Even if you make yours with a olive brine, a dirty martini, it tends to be, you know, sort of clear, so that contributes to it. One thing I didn't do that I should actually mention, I like just a dash of orange bitters in mine, maybe 2. It just sets it off a little bit better. Really contributes a little extra citrus notes to it. So if you are going with a martini, which you use the lemon zest as your garnish, which is what we're going to do, it adds a little bit to it. Anyway, should be good, nice and cold. We can use our Hawthorne strainer instead of the regular one. And we're going to get our glasses. Pre-chilled, of course. Pour it out. As you can see, a very, very clear cocktail. And as you take your lemon zest, you express a bit over the drink, then around the sides, and garnish. Ready to drink. Well, that's delicious. Obviously, this is a very spirit-forward drink, so it should matter what kind of vodka you use. In this case, it should be, you know, clean vodka. I wouldn't recommend using anything cheap, no pop-off, none of that sort of stuff. This weed was not too badly expensive, but it's 5 times distilled, which usually gets rid of any of the off flavors of it that some vodkas have. So I recommend any kind of good vodka. Grey Goose probably just fine, Belvedere or something like that. That's a delicious drink. It's especially tasty with that lemon. I don't know, something about vodka and lemon, they work very well together. Anyways, that's a very simple drink. I'm going to put that aside and finish it later. Because next up, we're going to do the Vesper Martini, which, again, came in to popularity in Casino Royale, the first James Bond book slash movie, whatever you want to, obviously the new reboot is the first one, Casino Royale, which didn't actually get made into a proper James Bond film until, you know, 2000s, whereas there was a version of Casino Royale made in the 60s, but it was very different. It was more of a comedy than anything else. It was Jimmy Bond, and I forget the Peter, not Lorre, but anyways, look it up. Interesting stuff. So, next up is the Vesper Martini. So, the Vesper Martini uses gin, the vodka, and it's supposed to be, Lillet Blanc, but Lillet Blanc is not in production, so we use cochi americano. Perfectly acceptable substitute. There's another one that I don't have access to that's supposed to be like an exact replica of Lillet Blanc, but this will work. Anyways, so it calls for 3 ounces of gin. This is a heavy cocktail. Like, 3 ounces of gin is a lot, and it's just like a splash of the cochi. So, 3 ounces of gin, 1 ounce of vodka. Obviously, because I'm not original, I'm sort of halfway copying another video that I saw. Well, it did come up with the idea before I saw it, but How to Drink talked about basically how in the novel, the drink is almost like a distraction because it's just such a, like, out there order. I mean, 3 ounces of vodka, or 3 ounces of gin, an ounce of vodka, and a half an ounce of the Lillet Blanc, which is actually... I mean, it's kind of an uncommon mixer. Like, most of the time you make a martini, you do regular old dry gin. Anyways. Calls for a half an ounce of this. I may go a little bit heavier on that. So, in general, martinis are, you know, long-distance drinks. They're sipping drinks. They're something that you're not going to sit there and just chug. It's supposed to be, you know, high-proof sort of thing that you drink over the course of an evening, in like an hour or something, which is why, A, it should be cold, very cold to begin with, so it remains relatively cold temperature. And B, that's why I usually don't have, like, a big one, and this is a big drink. But it's pretty fun. Pre-chilled glass, we'll do a little stir. Make sure it's nice and cold. The dilution is not so important as the temperature, but yeah, you do want to get a little bit of dilution going on there. Because again, it's a heavy drink. And 4 ounces of liquid. So, then we strain. When you rub your garnish around the outside, serve and enjoy. Oh yeah, that's a beefy boy. So yeah, the Vesper is an intense drink. It's definitely not one for the newbies, because it is fairly complicated. And at least, you know, flavor-wise, easy to make. But it is just boozy. It is heavy. It is a bad boy. Not as refreshing as a regular martini. Highly recommend just going with a regular martini. But the Vesper is a fun one to make. And I do like cochi. Cochi is a delicious thing in any drink. But anyways, give it a try. God rest Sean Connery. He's up in heaven, arriving at Wimbledon as his favorite time. Tarnish. Anyways, thanks for joining us today. Hit us up on the socials. We're on Facebook, we're on Twitter, we're on all that stuff. Instagram. Instagram seems to be most popular with us. We may actually start posting these on Instagram instead of YouTube. But if you are still watching them on YouTube, thank you for your support. Sandra, we're going to probably do the coquito on the next one for Christmas, since it is basically Puerto Rican eggnog. But yeah, we'll give that one a shot. Everybody else, you know, thank you again for watching the video. Share, like, subscribe, do all that fun stuff. Another announcement, we are currently in a partnership with a company called Bright Swimwear. And if you use our code TWL25 at checkout, you can get 25% off their swimwear. It's a brand out of Sweden, and they are their goal is to make swimwear for everyone. But it's a luxury brand. They're nice swim trunks. We're going to actually probably do a photo shoot and get some of our friends together and model some of the stuff for our listeners. So look forward to that. Also, Bright Swimwear, TWL25. Bright Swimwear, TWL25. Anyways, thank you again for joining us. See you next time. Bye.